exhibitions there. We, as I say, we brought Jimmy White back there, Ronnie O'Sullivan, Steve Davis, Judd Trump. And we've had the Legends Cups the last few years. But this time we are bringing back the Irish Masters, which I don't think has been played there since 98, I think, maybe 98.
Yeah, that's correct. Yeah, it's been a long time.
So it's all got a bit serious for a change.
And over the years, we've seen some fantastic players come. I've been lucky enough to be there, you know, day one. We all know, like, you know, the people's champion, Jimmy White. He's always in tremendous form when it comes to golf. Of course, the daring of Dublin, Ken Doherty, will be there. John Parrott, I'm actually very much looking forward to watching play as well. But we have to ask, because we know Steve Davis has been retired for a while now. How did you manage to pull that off? You've got some fierce power there.
well, you know, Steve Davis has always been a great friend of Snooker Legends. But when I took over the World Seniors and created the World Seniors Tour, Steve was very honest, and he said he didn't really want to play competitive snooker. He didn't want to practice anymore, because obviously, even though we've been largely based around exhibitions, it now gets a bit serious, and none of these guys want to not do themselves justice. They've got too much pride for that. And obviously, we're talking about a competition from over 40s, and Steve is nearly 60 years old, and he's got his own career away now, DJing. He's still the best snooker exhibition player you will find out there. But when we had a problem with Stephen Hendry and his a change of a date, which he was contracted to do in China, it was the obvious replacement. I went to Steve, and I thought it was going to be a tricky conversation to persuade him, and he said yes straight away. He said, as long as people don't take it as me making a comeback, he said, I would love to come to Goss and say goodbye one final time to the Irish fans, very much like he'd done in the Crucible when he retired there. So I don't think people should underestimate how much work he will put in, because he is practicing. I know he is. I've heard it on very good authority that he is practicing. Having a match up with Dennis Taylor is just fantastic. The last ever competitive match between the two players who probably staged the most famous snooker match in history, I would say.
Definitely. And it's a fantastic feed, Jason. Like, there's some great players there. What excites you most about coming back to Goss? Because I've always seen your face over the years. You're always excited. You're like a child at Christmas when you're at Goss.
Well, I am. Listen, I created Snooker Legends because I'm a snooker fan, and I wanted to create something that I would want to go to as a fan. And back in 2010, when we started it, there never used to be a chance to get access to the players, never a chance to say hello, to get an autograph. I mean, I understood it, but even now, I think what we started, World Snooker have incorporated a bit of their events, and there are some more opportunities. But we've always wanted to give access to the players, and the people have turned up year on year on year in Goss. And it's a really important place. It's steeped in snooker history. It's, you know, as I say, we talk about Steve Davis. I think he won the title 8 times in Goss, you know, and you get the receptions for the homegrown players. And I can promise you, we give opportunities to amateur players. And there's a guy from Leeds who people might not know yet, Jonathan Bagley, who's kind of the number 2, I think, world-ranked senior player at the moment. He thinks his Christmases have all come at once for a chance to walk out at Goss. So I think there's probably only the Crucible that people would say that potentially they'd want to play in more, but there is no roar like the crowd in Goss, I can promise you. It's fantastic.
Definitely. And as you say, the atmosphere, it's as I say, we're not far away, but the atmosphere is building nicely. A lot of people talking about it. There's a special event on the 5th. Can you just tell us a little bit about that for the fans?
Yeah, well, part of, as I say, our ethos and commitment to the fans is staging these events. Now, generally in the UK, like we have the UK seniors in the world, we like to put on a little bit of golf in the day. Now, even the most diehard fans, it's probably going to be a little bit cold in the first week of January to be hitting a golf ball around. But we've got Palmerston House, which is a beautiful stately home right next door to Goss. So next Friday evening, there's a gala dinner. and you can come along. It's a champagne reception. It's a three-course meal. There's a brilliant live band. All the legends will be there. You can sit with a legend at the table. It's a real evening to kick off the whole weekend. I mean, the ones who are playing at 1 o'clock the next day might go easy on the Guinness, but a few more who are not playing until later will certainly be dancing the night away. So it's a fantastic opportunity for any fans who really want a chance to see the guys in a relaxed atmosphere. And, of course, we've got a very, very special guest this year who, as I say, I always like to keep something up our sleeve and deliver something a bit different. And having the daughter of Alex Higgins with us all weekend as our special guest is something really special.
We can't wait for that. That's going to be fantastic. And Saturday and Sunday, we've got big days, of course. There's two sessions each day. And I believe the VIP package is available still, isn't there, for those?
Yeah, I think the VIP sold out for the Sunday, but I think you can still get them on Ticketmaster. I mean, every session gives you something to watch. I mean, and I was very conscious this year. I understand that people don't have, you know, an unlimited amount of income. You can get tickets to Goths for €10. You can't go and see a cinema. You can't go and see a film at the cinema for €10. And this, you know, if you come to Saturday afternoon, you'll get to see Jimmy White play Patrick Wallace. You know, Patrick will bring a big army of people down from the north to support him. Jimmy is probably more popular in Ireland than he is in England. Then you've got, as I say, John Parrott against Patsy Fagan. Patsy Fagan's another Irish major winner. You know, yeah. there's only been two major winners from the South, obviously Ken and Patsy. And Patsy gets a little bit forgotten sometimes, and Patsy's practicing hard. Then in the evening, you've got the Darling of Dublin, who's taking on the taxi driver from Leeds, which is just like a Rocky Balboa story, that one. And Ken won't underestimate Jonathan Bagley. He saw him play at the UK Senior Championship in October. And then, of course, Stevie Dennis to wrap it up. And, you know, these matches are our best of five. If it goes 2-2, then we go to the Blackpool restart. So I'm sure Steve Davis, the last thing he wants is a Blackpool shooting at David Taylor.
We can't wait, Jess. And we'll have all the links on the tickets and Ticketmaster up on our website as well. So I very much look forward to seeing you next week. It's going to be awesome.
Yeah, and as I say, I think the final is almost sold out. But what we're going to do is we're going to make some standing seats available. So if people, even if it is sold out, I think we'll make some standing tickets available, because Goths over the years has a history of two or three tiers of people standing, and we're allowed to have some standing seats in there. So, you know, come on down. We'll have some tickets on the door as well. Get in quick if you want a VIP. If you want to come to the dinner, get quick. But you can come down. You can meet all the legends. You can meet Lauren Higgins. You can share your stories of everything about her dad, Alex. It's going to be a brilliant weekend for any snooker fan. And, you know, thank you so much for your continued support and helping us with it, Jerry. I really appreciate it.
Anytime, Jason. I'm like a child at Christmas when it comes to this stuff. So it means a lot, sir. And we will see you next week. We can't wait. It's going to be a great event, as always. So thank you, sir.
You're welcome. All the best, Jerry.
Thank you, Jason. Have a good day. Thank you.
Bye-bye.